down by Brannigan's Corner one morning night at three. I met a fellow rebel, and to me he did say, we have orders from our captain to assemble at Dunbar. But how are we to get there without a motor car?
Oh, Barney, dear, be of good cheer, I'll tell you what we'll do. The specials, they are plentiful, but the IRA are few. We'll send a wire to Johnston to meet us at Stranlar, and we give the boys a bloody good ride in Johnston's motor car.
When Dr. Johnston heard the news, he soon put on his shoes. He said, this is an urgent case, there is no time to lose. He then put on his castor hat and on his breast a star. You could hear the din all through the bin of Johnston's motor car.
Ah, but when he got to the railway bridge, the rebels he saw there.
Our Johnston knew the game was up, but Agonade is here. He said, I have a permit to travel near and far.
To hell with your English permit, we want your motor car.
What will my loyal brethren think when they hear the news? My carriage has been commandeered by the rebels at Dunloose. We'll give you a receipt for it, all signed by Captain Barr.
How an Ireland gets her freedom, boy, you'll get your motor car. Well, they put that car in motion and filled it to the brim. With guns and bayonets shining, which made old Johnston grim. And Barney hoisted a Sinn Féin flag and a brother like a star. And we give three cheers to IRA and Johnston's motor car.
O'Driscoll drove with a song. The wild duck and the drake, from the tall and tufted reeds of a drear heart lake. And he saw how the reeds grew dark with the coming of night tide. And he dreamt of the long dim hair of Bridget, his bride. Then he heard it high up in the air, a piper piping away. And never was piping so sad, and never was piping so gay. Then he saw young men and young girls dance in a level place, with Bridget his bride among them, with a sad and a gay face. The dancers gathered around him, and many a sweet thing said. An old man brought him red wine, and a young girl white bread. But Bridget drew him by the sleeve, away from the merry band, to old men playing of cards with a twinkling of ancient hands. And he sat and he played in a dream, and he thought not of evil chance, till one bore Bridget his bride away to the merry dance. He bore her away in his arms, the handsomest young man there, and his lips and his neck and his arms were drowned in her long dim hair. O'Driscoll scattered the cards, and out of his dream awoke. And old men and young girls were gone like a drifting smoke. Then he heard it high up in the air, a piper piping away. And never was piping so sad, and never was piping so gay.